The Saudi war machine continues to claim the lives of Yemeni civilians by committing two new horrific massacres in Hajja and Al Jawf governorates. As Riyadh attempts with this policy to pressure Sana'a to stop its advancement near the city of Ma'rib, Washington and London elevated their support to Mohammed bin Salman by using the lamest excuse. An oil tanker named FSO Safir that has been moored 7 kilometers off the coast of Yemen since 1980. Yes, you heard that right. The international community is going above and beyond to pressure the Yemeni armed forces and the Ansarullah resistance to surrender the port of Hudaydah, which they have been controlling since the beginning of the Saudi genocidal war on Yemen on March 2015, by claiming the oil tanker is a time bomb. All the while, Saudi Arabia escalated its campaign of violence against Yemeni civilians last week, killing 9 people in Al Jawf governorate, including 4 children. This attack came on July 16, just 3 days after an air raid that killed at least 6 children and 2 women, bringing the total number of civilians killed in the past week to 17, including 10 children. Yemeni children are paying with their lives in a war they have no part in, leaving families torn apart while the airstrikes continue to indiscriminately target civilians. According to the Yemeni Data Project, in the first 6 months of 2020, there was a 139% increase in bombing rates by the Saudi and Emirati-led coalition compared to the last 6 months of 2019. The escalation in violence in recent weeks comes after the UN Secretary General failed to list the Saudi and Emirati-led coalition in their annual report on children and armed conflict for all the grave violations the coalition committed against children in Yemen in 2019. This same international community, including the UN that is crying a river over the Safir oil tanker, is fully responsible for these massacres by removing the Saudi-led coalition from the list of shame for targeting children in Yemen. This only encourages Mohammed bin Salman to continue his brutal crimes against the people of Yemen and thus undermining any prospect for peace. Welcome to the Middle East Stream. I'm Marwa Osman.